It's not here!
I don't understand it. We've looked everywhere.
Now think about it. If we've looked everywhere, we would have looked where it is, but since we haven't found it, we haven't looked everywhere.
What?
Have you found it?
No. Sorry, boss.
How could I have lost the naughty and nice list?
Why don't you take a break? You need it for the Christmas Eve trip.
There won't be a trip. I'll get the presents mixed up.
Come on, let's double check the places we've already looked.
How could I have lost the most important thing about Christmas? Now the nice children won't get rewarded, and the naughty children will think they can get by with anything.
Hey boss, just heard about the naughty and nice list. Any luck finding it?
No, and we've just about run out of places to look.
Well, I'll go and try and find the others. Won't you just take a nap?
I can't nap at a time like this. I'm going to the control room to see if I can put together a new list. Now, who was nice and who was naughty? Susie, Bill, Bartholomew. Do I even know Bartholomew? Oh, this will never work.
Well, one of us might as well get in a few winks. After all, there really isn't much to do without the naughty and nice list.
Did you hear that? They can't find the naughty and nice list.
I wanted a home.
What if I end up at a naughty girl's house? What if she rips me? What if she tears my dress? She can even rip my arm off. We have to do something.
What did they stuff you with,
sugar?
What are you doing?
Doesn't she look a little too relaxed?
What do you mean?
Think about it. Everybody else is running around frantically looking for the list. Then there's this elf, just sitting there with her feet up.
Now that you mention it, she does look a little relaxed.
I bet she has the list.
That's impossible. An elf would never do something that mean. Would she?
Well, she has nothing to do because it's gone.
You're right. Well, let's get it then.
Wait a minute. We don't even know if she's guilty.
Oh, she's guilty, all right. She has beady eyes.
How can you tell? They're closed.
I noticed them when she was awake.
Somebody's coming. Quick, back to the show.
I wish I knew where else to look.
What are you doing here?
Looking for the naughty and nice list?
We've already looked in here.
I think we're going to have to give up.
We can't do that. We'll disappoint too many kids.
I don't know what else to do.
Santa says something about a new list. Any luck, boss?
I can't even remember the names, much less if they've been naughty or nice.
So what's plan B?
Making a new list was plan B. Do we have a plan C?
Plan C is to cancel Christmas.
We can't cancel Christmas. It's never been done.
Well, there's a first time for everything. I would have liked to have been remembered for doing something good instead of canceling Christmas.
Well, I think all you need is a vacation. Why don't we all take some time off and enjoy the sun? Florida's nice this time of year.
Are you kidding?
We can't go to Florida. We have work to do.
There won't be any work if there isn't any Christmas. I guess I'll go break the news to Miss Claus. At least I'll be home this year, but I'm afraid I won't be very good company.
We have to do something. I can't just stand here and see the boss's way.
Hey, maybe we could come up with a plan. Let's go down to the assembly line and meet with all the elves. Maybe they'll have some ideas.
Okay, I guess that won't hurt. Are you coming?
I'll be there in a minute. I have some things I have to do first.
Okay, but hurry.
Okay, maybe taking the list wasn't such a good idea. But it's too late now. Those kids never appreciate all the hard work we do anyways. What's one less toy to them? They don't even play with the ones they have now. Well, I guess I better go put a stop to any new plans. I told you she has beady eyes!
She has worse than beady eyes. She has a cold heart. How could somebody who makes toys for kids all around the world all year be so mean?
We have to change her mind. Make her say that she's wrong about the children of the world. Then we'll beat her up!
It was just a thought.
You realize we're gonna have to reveal the secrecy of us coming to life, right?
That's a risk we'll have to take.
It's our duty.
Our responsibility.
We have to save Christmas!
but I got goosebumps.
We need a plan.
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, that's the best one yet. Oh, I'm sure that'll work.
Yeah, set up a giant satellite receiver and watch all the kids all over the world. This close to Christmas, they aren't trying to cover up what big brats they've been over the year.
Can we speak to you?
Who are you?
We're the Christmas toys. The ones you and the other elves have been working on.
But you can't speak.
Guess again, buddy.
This must be some kind of dream. I must have fallen asleep in that stupid meeting the elves were having about saving Christmas. That's it. I'm asleep.
Ouch! What was that for?
I just wanted to show you that you weren't asleep. Well, if I'm not asleep, then it must be something I ate. That's it. Heartburn.
It can't be heartburn.
Why not?
Because your heart is too cold.
Look, we can walk, we can talk. We come to life when we need to.
And we need to now.
Why?
Because you're about to ruin Christmas? That's why?
And we heard you talking about taking the naughty and nice list.
What makes you think I have the naughty and nice list?
Because you sat right there and talked about going to Florida.
Look, we're wasting time. We know that you have the list, and we also know that you're not going to give it to us.
Voluntarily!
We're going on a little trip.
Where are we?
Well, we're here to show you that you were wrong about greedy children.
Dear Santa, I know it's kind of late to be writing to you, and I hope you get this.
Oh, I've heard this a million times. Dear Santa, I've been so good. Bring me a bike, a doll, a ball, a train, and $1,000,000.
Somebody asked for $1,000,000?
They might as well. They want it all, everything they can get.
I've been very good this year.
See?
My father recently lost his job, and I feel bad asking for presents when my family needs so much. So please, Santa, all I want for Christmas this year is something that will make me and my family happy again. Please, Santa, we know you can think of something. We need your help.
Don't tell me that didn't make you feel sad.
Let's try this again.
Dear Santa, I'm living in foster home, the second one this year. My foster parents are very nice to me, but for Christmas this year, all I want is a home of my own.
So do we.
Please.
Let's do it again.
Third time's a charm.
Dear Santa, I have a special wish for Christmas this year. My friend's dad just got transferred to a new city, and I'm worried that since it's so close to Christmas, you might not know where she lives. So I'm sending you her address just to make sure you visit her house this Christmas.
What? No clever response? Don't tell me you have nothing to say. She was just trying to make Santa feel sorry for the family so she'll get a lot of presents.
Let's try this one last time.
If this does not work, I'm beating her up.
Dear Santa, school has been hard this year again. I know it's important to pay attention to the teacher and make good grades, but sometimes I just can't. Last year I asked you to help me in school, so you sent me some new colors, pencils, and a cool notebook. You also said that you would send me a good teacher, and you did. I love Miss Kraft. She tells me how smart I am when I try very hard. I don't want a gift these new Santa. Just give something really nice to Miss Kraft. Maybe something from Starbucks. She loves coffee. Love, Eleanor.
Yeah, right.
Check the list.
You have. Just see if their names are on the list.
Santas. Yep, they're here, with circles and bright red stars.
What does that mean?
Those are the extra nice ones, the ones who get their wishes first.
You were right, and I was wrong.
Oh, I love sunsets!
It's time to come clean.
What will I tell Santa?
Just tell him you found the list.
You don't have to tell him that you found it in your hat.
But I need your help. You don't need us. You know the right thing to do.
I guess we need to start notifying the authorities about canceling Christmas.
Santa?
Yeah, what is it?
Did you hear that?
That was me. I have a frog in my throat.
Well, spit it out. We don't have all day, you know.
Well, you see.
If this could wait, I really have more pressing business.
I found the list.
What? You found the list?
Yes. Here.
Where was it? It doesn't matter. The important thing is that you found the list. Come on. We have work to do. Congratulations. You saved Christmas.
There now. Don't you feel better?
No.
Why not?
Because Santa thinks I'm a hero, but I'm not. I'm a thief.
But you did the right thing in the end.
Someone's coming.
No time for the show.
Drop where you are!
I just wanted to say how proud we are of you, and Santa says you have done enough, and you can take the rest of the season off.
Did you say something?
Yes, I said I didn't find the list, I took it.
I beg your pardon?
Let's just say I've been shown the error of my ways. Children aren't all that greedy, and without Christmas, children would stop hoping and dreaming.
Well, did you get the news? You can go to Florida after all.
No, I can't.
Why not?
Because she says she wants to stay after all. She got off with the magic of Christmas.
Whatever you want.
Why'd you do that?
Blame it on the season. You did the right thing in the end, and that's what's most important. Now, let's get to work. I'll be there in a minute. I need to put these back up on the shelf. You guys were right. It turned out okay in the end.
We knew it would.
That was our plan.
Well, I've got to go tag toys for new homes. Any requests?
A home with a soft bed.
A home with a fluffy pillow to keep all my arms and legs.
What? I'm just being practical. Let's see here. How's that? I couldn't have said it better myself. Well, thanks, guys, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, we'd better rest up. We have a big day ahead of us.
You're rather emotional, aren't you?
I always try happy endings.
Hey, have you guys seen the Naughty and Nice list?
What?
Yeah, Santa put it down somewhere and he can't remember where.
Oh no, here we go again.
outside, all the stockings are hung by the fireside. Welcome, everyone, and Merry Christmas! We have a great story for you tonight about a young elf named Randy, fresh from the Elf Academy, who wants to make a big impression her first day on the job.
The time is just a few weeks before Christmas, and the place is, of course, the North Pole. Everyone's scrambling to have everything ready for Santa and the biggest night of the year.
Randy is understandably a little unsure of herself.
Let's look in at the workshop right now.
Wow, Santa's workshop. I can't believe I'm actually here.
Hey, kid. Are you new? I haven't seen you around here before.
Hi, I'm Randy. Today's my first day.
Welcome, Randy. The name's Francis.
Glad to meet you. To tell you the truth, I'm kind of nervous.
Aw, nothing to it, kid. Come with me and meet some of the guys.
Hey, Francis, who's the newer crew?
Ramona, Randy, Randy, Ramona.
Why, hello there, Randy. Sorry, I have to get back to work.
Hey, Francis, who's the newer crew?
Randy, this is Pete. Pete makes our most popular toy tote benches.
These are amazing. Nice to meet you, Pete.
Likewise, Randy.
Fred here is our electronic game wizard.
I love electronic games.
I'm pretty fond of it myself, Randy. Welcome to the workshop.
I'm glad to be here.
Emily and Grace are our doll maker extraordinaires.
Hi, Randy. First day?
Does it show?
No, you're fine.
Ho, ho, ho! Good morning, elves!
Hey, big guys!
What's up? I certainly hope you all had a good night's sleep, because we have a big problem on our hands.
I wonder what's up. It's not like the boss to be so serious.
Elves, from the looks of my mail, our usual production isn't going to be quite enough this year.
What's the matter, Santa? Are we not making enough toys this year?
We've been working so hard, I haven't even had time to get a manicure!
No, no, our volume is just fine. You're all doing a wonderful job. It's just, I think we need to add something spectacular this year. Any ideas, anyone?
We could step up our electronic division, Santa.
You've already done that, Fred, and I appreciate it, but we need something brand new and different. I'm talking Toy of the Year!
I think I might just have an idea, Francis.
Speak up. Go for it, kid.
Excuse me, Santa, sir?
Ah, Randy, our newest team member. Do you have something in mind?
Well, yes, Santa, I do. How about a robot?
Ho, 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 we have plenty of those already, my elf. They march around in circles by themselves. But that is about it.
No, Santa, I'm talking about a useful robot. One that every kid would want. How about a robot that does chores?
I think it's a great idea, Santa.
Sounds like a winner to me.
Think it could be Toy of the Year?
Well, yes, Santa, I do.
Well, I like it. And since it was your idea, Randy, I'm going to let you be in charge of developing it.
Me? But Santa, I'm brand new here.
No problem, my elf. I've got an empty workbench right over here that has your name on it. Wow, look at the time. I have got to get going. Randy, I'll expect to see this robot a week from today. Ho, ho, ho!
A week? I can invent a robot in a week.
Take it easy. I have plenty of scrap metal, and you can use my blowtorch.
Yeah, we have lots of tools and batteries over in electronics.
Toolboxes are my specialty, Randy. You can use anything you need.
And you can buy some of our painting division.
Okay, thanks everyone. Guess I'd better get busy.
You can do this, Randy.
Randy spent the next week working on her robot, putting everything she learned at the Elf Academy to good use.
Back and forth she went from department to department, borrowing tools, gathering materials, and getting advice.
She tested all the circuitry carefully, making sure everything was connected properly, and then installed the internal computer.
Next, she programmed the robot to perform a simple chore.
Everything seemed to be going well.
But all too soon, the week had passed,
It was time for Randy to show the robot to Santa. Let's see how things are going.
Wow, Randy, your robot looks amazing.
Thanks, Francis. I haven't had enough time to work on it, so it might be a little rough on the edges.
I'm sure Santa will love it.
I sure hope so, Ramona.
Ho, 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 good morning, Al.
Hey,
now, Randy, I've been looking forward to seeing this all week. Let's see your robot in action.
Robot, pick up those clothes.
No way!
Robot sweep! Robot sweep the floor!
Forget it!
I don't like where this is going.
Me either.
Robot, pick up those toys.
No can do.
This isn't Toy of the Year. This is Disaster of the Year.
No, Santa, it worked before I showed it to you.
Well, it certainly doesn't work now. I'm sorry, Randy, but I'm sending you back to the Elf Academy for retraining.
No, Santa, give me another chance.
Take it easy on him, Santa.
Yeah, Santa, he's just a kid.
All right, tell you what. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'll give you until first thing tomorrow morning to fix your robot.
Thank you, Santa.
You're welcome, but just remember, if it still doesn't work then, it's back to the Elf Academy for you.
I'll figure it out, Santa, I promise.
Good luck. Quitting time, everyone. See you in the morning, Randy.
Randy spent the whole night taking her robot apart, piece by piece.
She tested the wiring batteries, then ran a check on the computer program.
When she was sure everything was in perfect working order, she reassembled her robot.
With dawn approaching, Randy knew she was almost out of time. She ran one last test on her robot.
Robot, I really want you to be the Toy of the Year. This is our last chance. Are you ready?
Ready.
Robot, pick up the screwdriver. Oh, come on, Robot. I know you understand me. I really want you to be the Toy of the Year. If only you do what you're supposed to do. I know you. This is terrible. Kids all over the world hate doing their chores. Half the time, they don't even do them. Then they get yelled at, and things go downhill from there, and they wind up on the naughty list. Wait a minute. That's it. Kids don't do their chores, and then they get yelled at. No one likes to get yelled at. I bet you don't either.
Do you, Robot? No, Randy, I do not.
Robot, if I ask you nicely, would you do some chores for me?
Of course, Randy.
Just in time, because the workshop's about to open and Santa will be here any minute.
Hey, Randy, did you fix that tin can of yours?
I think I did, Francis.
And not a moment too soon, here comes the boss. Ho, ho, ho! Good morning, Al!
Santa!
Good morning, Randy. I hope your robot is working properly now.
I think it is, Santa. Well, here it goes. Robot, could you please pick up those toys?
Of course, Randy.
Robot, could you please sweep the floor?
Right away, Randy.
Look at him go!
You go, Robot.
Hey, you're pretty good, Robot.
Thank you, Ted. I enjoy coffee.
Robot, could you please pick up those clothes?
It would be my pleasure.
Now that's more like it. How'd you fix your robot, Randy?
It wasn't broken, Santa. I yelled at Robot instead of Axe. She just didn't like all that shouting.
Well, that makes sense. Well, I must say, I'm very impressed. But I do have just one question for you, Robot.
Ask away, Santa.
You don't happen to do homework, do you?
No, Santa. My program is exclusively confined to manual labor. No cheating on homework allowed.
Then that settles it. In recognition of your hard work, ingenuity, and perseverance, I hereby proclaim your robot Toy of the Year!
Yeah!